For years, I've been hearing all about how incredible Yellowstone is. I was curious, but there's just so much to watch I never quite got around for it. I kept hearing about it more and more over the years, which piqued my curiosity, but it also got to this tipping point where I was afraid no matter how good the show was, it wouldn't be able to live up to the hype. Yellowstone, created by Taylor Sheridan and John Linson, premiered in June of 2018. It did premiere to mixed reviews by audiences and critics. The viewers acknowledged that the show was ambitious in its storytelling and performances, but they all felt that the writing and pacing were a bit wobbly. And these early audiences weren't wrong. The first season doesn't feel like anything too special. It's better than many, but not anything extraordinary. It does do enough to keep you watching. And as season one comes to a close, we get to see where Sheridan wants to take the characters and the drama. The show quickly begins earning its reputation. The performances were strong across the board. That was it from the start. And it was basically unanimous that Kevin Costner was crushing the role as the family patriarch, John Dutton. Another place Yellowstone shone from the very start was in its cinematography, showcasing how beautiful and vast Montana is, along with the very real feeling depictions of how incredibly difficult running a ranch actually is. These two concepts are made for the era of affordable massive HD screens in everyone's home. Despite a rocky start and a formulaic feeling in the first season, Yellowstone finds its audience. Americans have always loved a good Western, and Yellowstone delivers on that front. It also has an interesting way of tapping into other genres that found success recently. The family dynamics are like something out of Succession, except for without the constant and exhausting shifting of allegiances that seem to happen four times per episode. The dynamics between the Dutton family and other powerful organizations borrows heavily from mob and gangster stories. Some of the larger plots do feel typical for standard network TV. The series is honest about many other things. I mentioned the depictions of how tough ranching is, the even tougher life of making a living through rodeo, but then more immediate and human interest pieces also hit. Land rights, where our food comes from, what it means to be a rancher, monocrop agriculture, holding on to old ways, family, responsibility, second chances. These are where the show is elevated to be something truly incredible. Kevin Costner is the big name star that brings star power to the series. Because of this fact alone, I thought he would just dominate every scene. Costner does some of his best work in years on Yellowstone. His character often takes a back seat as far as screen time goes, but his presence is always felt. The less is more approach to John Dutton works perfectly. Luke Grimes, Kelly Riley, and Wes Bentley play the Dutton children that get the most focus. All of their characters appear to be one way on the outside and another way when it goes deeper into who each of them actually are. They all have interesting backstories that logically and perfectly lay the groundwork for why they are the way they are in the current run of the show. There's an impressive level of consistency from the first episode on that keeps the characters the same at their core, but also allows for personal growth. Kelly Riley is the standout for me in this regard. The things in her past that damaged her come out in the form of extreme power. Riley's Beth Dutton is the most intriguing character by far, and even after five full seasons, I don't get tired of scenes where she seems backed into a corner and then shreds her opponent. The Dutton Ranch is run by a crew of cowboys. These characters are almost like an offshoot show. Their personalities come through in the limited time we get to spend with them. The senior cowboy, Lloyd Pierce, played by Forey J. Smith, and the man who runs their day-to-day, Rip Wheeler, played by Cole Hauser, are big time standouts. Rip Wheeler is one of my favorite types of characters. I refer to him as the true believer. He's a stoic man of rock solid principles and loyalty. He puts duty above all else. Wheeler's weight when he plays Rip, especially when Rip is kicking the crap out of someone who really deserves it, is incredible. The only character I feel the scripts fail is Kelsey Asbeley's Monica Dutton. She seems to get a new personality every handful of episodes for whatever the story might need at the time. She's an educator, a wife, a mother, fiercely determined, a fan of the ranch. She's against the ranch, a damsel in defense. She's capable one minute and defenseless the next. She's all in on her marriage and then wants out of her situation the next second. People are complicated, so that entire list could be forgiven. Where the show fails her is when they sideline her entirely. Yellowstone is a series that started off typical, but by the middle of the first season was something special. By the start of the second season was something incredible, and I can see why it's getting all the hype that it does. By a couple seasons in, this was my latest TV obsession. Not only that, but there's an extra bonus for lovers of the series. Once you catch up on all of Yellowstone, there are a couple prequel series made by the same creators, so you have that same dedication to quality.